Back now to the disaster in the Gulf. A conservation group shooting a videotape it says shows BP crews are dumping sand on top of the oil on Louisiana beaches, perhaps an attempt to cover it up, not clean it up.
What you're seeing here is where the sand that they have dumped on the beaches has eroded down. And if you look about four layers down, you see that it's covering up oil.
Well, we reached out to BP to comment on the story. We got no response. No response. I repeat that. With me now, the man who shot the videotape, Judson Parker, the executive director of Save Our Shores. It's a nonprofit marine conservation group. Its website, saveourshores.org. Look, people can fiddle with videotape, and people can interpret videotape. But tell me what you claim you saw.
Well, you know, we've been trying to document the beaches, you know, from Louisiana to Florida. We started at Grand Isle, and we went out as soon as some of the bands from Hurricane Alex had moved out of the way. We walked down to the shores, and we could tell there were piles of sand that looked like it had been imported. It was a lot different texture, very gritty, filled with a lot of shells. Later on, we jumped over the boom that was separating the back part of the beach from the actual shoreline. And when we got there, we could tell that the sand that was actually on the beach part was a little bit different than that was a little bit higher up. And we noticed, we started stepping on tarballs, and we started to see the erosion and decided to investigate and look at it. And lo and behold, buried underneath a layer of oil, under a layer of sand, rather, was a layer of oil. And we were just, we weren't expecting
Well, but couldn't
to see
that be a natural phenomenon? I mean, how do you know that BP dumped sand on top of the oil?
Well, we don't really want to speculate on it too much, but we did speak with some local sheriffs who did confirm that BP was bringing in sand and dumping it.
Did you see it?
As well as a couple of locals. We didn't see it ourselves. We just saw the sand that was already dumped. You know, one thing that could be a possibility...
Whoa. You say you saw the sand that was already dumped. How do you know
right.
It was dumped?
Well, it was a different kind of sand from the sand that's actually on the beach. Instead of the white sand that you would see on the beach, it was more of a sort of a gritty dirt.
All right. But that's an assumption, right? I mean, I'm trying to be fair here.
Well, that's totally fine. Yeah, I mean, we did see piles of sand on the beach. You could tell where they had piled it up. If you were building sand berms with it on the beach to try to protect some parts of the shore with the sand as well.
So is that their deliberate intent is to, you know, I mean, maybe they're trying to build up the berms out there and protect the shoreline?
Well, that is a possibility. The big thing that we're concerned about here is that, you know, whether it's through tidal interaction or through intentional dumping, it's the sand is hiding, you know, toxic oil in a place where it's much less likely to get.
And do you, Judson, do you think that's their intent to hide the evidence of damage?
Well, I want to be fair and say that I don't want to speculate on that. Mm-hmm. We're just trying to document what we see, and it does look like someone has come out and dumped. You know, Grand Isle is a place where they do escort media through certain areas where they bring politicians, and I think it's to their advantage to make the beaches look as pristine as they can when those folks come down.
Sure. All right, Judson, it's an important story. Will you keep us abreast of what's happening? Let us know what's going on. What do you see? Thank you very much.
Certainly.
Judson Parker.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.